what's the cool website nowadays?
Stableless. It's
stableless.
Yes.
Oh, these are new words.
No, because I'm saying stableless because the OPS site right now is stable.
Stable.
It doesn't show well in other browsers.
Okay.
So they need to be web free right now.
Uh-huh. Yeah, they really have to conform to professional standards.
Uh-huh. Okay, and then what else?
When it comes to social media, I just want to echo again what I said earlier. Now, don't just use it for feedback because that's a shallow way of maximizing the power and harnessing the power of social media.
Mm-hmm.
Try
mm-hmm.
to figure out a way to integrate it into the different government functions.
Mm-hmm.
And don't just look at Facebook. Look at the internet as a whole.
Mm-hmm.
What things can you do? What applications can you do to reach to the Filipino people to give them better lives? So I think that's a challenge.
Okay. But Carlo, you did say earlier that not everybody has internet access, right? I mean, that's one problem that we face as a developing country. How can you overcome that? And will you reach a majority of the public you want to reach?
It's exponentially growing.
It's growing
at a very fast rate. We're already at 30% of the population. And I think the biggest thing that people don't see is, don't just look at the broadband subscribers.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Look at the number of internet cafes, because that's a form of access
mm-hmm.
for users who want to go to the internet. In Davao, there are promos there that, 2 to 5 pesos per hour.
Wow.
So it's very, very affordable. And I think that will be the main driver in getting more Filipinos mm-hmm. Online. And of course, if the government campaigns and, passes laws that will make internet access
even easier,
then it will be much better
okay.
for everyone.
And your blogs, Noemi, how are they doing? And what's your objective now that the president is in office?
Not everybody's writes, so not everybody blogs also. But some people rather read and some... So that's what it is. So we provide information and diverse views.
Mm-hmm.
We'll continue to be a good governance watch, and because we saw President Noynoy from the start,
mm-hmm.
and we saw him, we interviewed him, and mm-hmm. we saw him grow.
Mm-hmm.
So it would be good to monitor him and mm-hmm. his promises.
Okay, will social networking sites be as fiercely critical or fiercely observant as the traditional media people are? I mean, the traditional media people are keeping a hawk's eye on what's going to happen.
Well, in social networking, they're more critical.
They're critical?
Yeah, because they can. They don't have any
rules.
So they're supposed to be opinionated. They don't have no holds barred on it.
Okay. In that sense, more dangerous, right?
Yeah. Right. That's why there are certain sites that should bring down the noise down so that the real issues are brought out.
Yeah.
Because some are just garbage,
Some are just noise.
Yes, it's noise.
Okay.
Bring it down.
And
that's what blogging does too.
That's
bring
right.
the relevant voices out.
Okay. Well, thank you very much, Noemi and Carlo, for joining us tonight.
You.
We leave you with a look at week 2 of the Aquino cabinet and its relationship with the media. I'm Cheche Lazaro from Media in Focus. We'd like to thank you very much for joining us tonight. We'll see you again next week. Good night.
The cabinet's relationship with the media got off to a rocky start, with the bloopers of presidential spokesperson Edwin Lacerda and Education Secretary Armin Luistro on their first day in office. Last week, Foreign Affairs Secretary Alberto Romulo became the latest cabinet member to clash with the press. Romulo lost his cool when journalist Helen Tordesillas pressed for answers on the extension of the term of political ambassador.
You're questioning my judgment. That was my judgment. That was my judgment. Siguro kung ikaw ang Secretary of Foreign Affairs, you would not. But me, my judgment was to give them that.
But the tension between reporters and President Noynoy Aquino's official family eased up after the cabinet took a media relations seminar. The seminar seems to be effective, with a visibly more relaxed Lacerda chasing the Malacanang press corps and even joking with them.
Available on Sunday.
Luiso also warmed up to reporters.
Sabi ko yung tagpulin ko dyan, pwede na natin ibigay dun sa mga media na galit pa sa akin. Pwede mo yung dartboard.
Other department heads are beginning to understand the work of journalists.
Now I know that you have to get a story every day, that you need to get stories and stuff like that. So that's why I shouldn't get irritated when you ask questions, because you're just doing your job. Media is the formula for us to reach the people. I shouldn't be running when you guys come running around. Because you're the way we're going to get that message across.
The president himself indulged the media in his first press briefing. He welcomed change from former President Arroyo, who let her spokesperson do all the talking. As for the little president, Executive Secretary Jojo Ochoa admits dealing with the media is something he still has to get used to.
Ochoa! Ano ito ginawa? Teto, di ba? Wala ka naman yung sa intention, di ba? So yun yung kinakata ko, hindi yung about what I can say or what I can say.
After the first few days, it seems the cabinet is finally adjusting to life in the executive to the glare of the public eye.